Hey there folks, Gary Bradley here, and in this episode I'm going to take you through some of the highlights in the March 2020 update to Adobe Illustrator. So, first new feature is Live Draw. So let me show you how it used to work. So you'd take your selection tool, you'd click on an element or a group, and you click and drag, and then the original, as it was before you dragged it, stays on screen where it is with all its output characteristics, its fills, its strokes, and so on and so forth. What you move around is a wireframe version. You move this around, and it's not until you let go of the mouse that you'll then see things like, is this object in front or behind of the tree artwork here? And you have to, let go of the mouse to see the update on the screen. However, now, if I go up to the Illustrator menu on the Mac and then go down to Preferences and then choose Performance, that of course is under the Edit menu and Preferences on a PC. When I click on that, down at the bottom now we have a new checkbox for real-time drawing and editing. When that's turned on and I click OK, that is an immediate change. You don't have to reboot for that one. Now, when I hover over and click on this object and drag, it just moves with everything on screen in there. Notice that it moves in front, it moves behind stuff. So if your computer, your hard drive, your graphics card can handle that kind of thing, I would say that this is a really nice bit of visual feedback on this edition in here, and something that I've wanted for quite a while. So that is Live Draw and editing. As I say, the hotkey for Preferences is Command K or Control K on a PC, and it's down to Performance, and you can turn that on and off at any time in there. So the other thing that changed as well was an enhancement, and this is to the free transform tool. So if I select this tree artwork down here and zoom into it, tapping the E key on the keyboard, and then you'll get to the free transform tool. So this, of course, it allows you to do things like scale, rotate, shear. Also, you can choose the perspective distort option in there to change the angle of one edge. But we have also had free distort. Now, when I click on free distort, you then essentially work with pins on the corners of this object in here. The thing with this was, if I just move this out of the way, when you drag and manipulate this around, you make the edits that you want in here. The only downside to this is that when you're done editing and you went back to the selection tool, this box around here and its nose would reset to be like a perfect rectangle that's wrapped around the width and the height of the object. It then meant that when you came back in here to make edits again, you're not working with these nodes in the place where they were left before. So this was a little bit frustrating. It made things a bit harder to work with. So in my case now, when I switch back to the selection tool, click away, go back and select the object, then go back to the free transform tool, you'll notice that the nodes and the frame is positioned exactly the same way it was before. You can then jump back to free distort, you can drag the handles around, and it just makes, you know, that guesstimation of dragging and moving that around a lot easier now with that addition in there. So that's a welcome thing. Feels more intuitive now, keeping that shape of the bounding box around your object. So I have saved the best feature until last, which is copy, cut and paste artboards. Now, I can't tell you how long I have waited for this feature. I'm so pleased this is now inside of Illustrator. So if you wish to, you can copy not just one, but as many artboards as you wish inside of an active open document. You can cut them, you can copy them, and then you can paste them into the same document or in another document that is open inside of Illustrator. Now, you won't be able to go over the threshold of 999 artboards in the same file, but hey, who on earth ever has that many artboards in a document? So you have to be in artboard editing mode to copy and paste your artboards. How do we do that? Well, if I bring the properties panel over here, you can, if you like using the properties panel, you've got a mode there to jump straight into artboard editing mode. Or you can go to the lower quarter of the tools panel and you can go to the artboard tool. It's got a hotkey of Shift and O. So if I click on that, it will then select the active artboard in your document. Now, I only happen to have one artboard in this particular file. Notice at the top up here, it reads artboard 01. It's called Wildlife. So it does have a bearing, and I'll come to that in a second. Also notice that up here in my control panel, it tells me that I have my artwork active to be copied and pasted as well. And that's been around inside of Illustrator for some time. That is in the form of a checkbox down here. So if you're going to move your artwork around inside of Illustrator, If you want to take the artwork and copy and paste it, that has to be on as well to include the artwork. And then from here, well, you just go up to edit and you choose copy. Go to the tab for the destination file. And then here, you can go to edit and then you can choose paste. And it pastes the artboard into your document. Now you'll notice that the gaps between the artboard that I've just pasted and the others in the document that were already in here are slightly smaller. And it's because Illustrator tends to go back to its sort of default of leaving a 20-point gap between the artboards. I mean, it's active, so you could click and hold down the mouse, you can drag, you could use smart guides just to move that around, but that is really good time saver inside of Illustrator. So pleased about that one. And so conversely, if I wish to, I could click on this artboard, hold down the shift key and shift and left click across the top four in here, go up to edit, choose copy, and then go back to my other file. If I just zoom out of touch in here to start off with and then go to edit and choose paste, it pastes those artboards in there. So again, just be aware, it will keep the same gaps between the artboards as were existing in the previous document, but you might notice there was some artwork just in this portion here, just in the pasteboard. So if you are going to paste artboards, just be aware that it will paste them in front of any artwork that's in the pasteboard area as well. If you wish to honor the layer structure when you copy and paste, then make sure you go to the layers panel and choose from the panel flyout menu, paste remembers layers, and then it will recall and honor all the layer structure in your source file when you copy an artboard, and then subsequently it will paste them in there into the destination file as well. So pretty good options that we have available in there. If I just go back to this document, if I go down here, notice that this document artboard has, it's artboard now 11, wildlife. Notice that artboard number one was already called wildlife. So it will update the number, but not the name of the artboard by default. So you will probably have to go in here. And if you wish to, if you're one of those people that names your artboards, always a good thing when you're exporting, then you'd have to change the name of that in there. So I'd maybe call that something like Trek Summer, just to give it a different name. So that is something that you will at this moment in time have to make as a manual edit once you've copied and pasted your artboard. Other things to be aware of, if you go to Illustrator and then down to preferences, and if you choose selection and anchor display, then oddly enough there is an option there called move locked and hidden artwork with artboard. So again, as before inside of Illustrator, if you wanted to move items, then you could move stuff that was hidden all locked on the artboard and it would move with it. But this now also applies to copying and pasting. So if you want to include guides and if you have stuff that's hidden on the artboard, make sure you turn that checkbox on as well to avoid disappointment. But there we go, folks. That is the roundup of the best new features and updates inside of Illustrator CC 2020 March release. As always, folks, if you've enjoyed the video and found it of value, please give it a thumbs up. And if you're not a subscriber and you wish to save tons of time and create awesome artwork, then you can subscribe, click on the bell so you don't miss a future video. And until next time, farewell, folks.